Hello everyone, welcome back to Mayuri's Talk channel. Now in this tutorial, we are going to see our last subtopic, which is the inner class of a third unit. Okay, now inner class, as in the name only is there, you can understand inner class means which is the class which will be inside the another class. As we know, a class is a collection of a data members and the methods. Okay, data members are there and member functions are there. Data members, which are nothing but the properties of a class, and the methods are there, which are nothing but the behavior of a class. But a class can have another class. Yes, it have another class. Just remember, there is not a specific reason to have an inner class. If there is some relation for outer class and inner class, for that purpose we use a inner class. Then how exactly we are going to call the methods of a inner class, there is something a different way. So that things we are going to say, this inner class, just know how exactly we are going to call it, what exactly means we are going to, that class will be served with. So this, all the things we are going to cover. So here if you see, here I have took regarding the same example, right? Now here if you see, a class outer, here I have took a class, and class can have a methods and a data members, which are nothing but the properties and behavior of a class. Now here you can take any of a variable regarding the class. I here I have took a method as a show in the curly bracket, that system outer, that whatever will be there that we are going to pass here, so that it will be outputted. Now here in the outer class, here I have took a inner class. Okay, class, inner class. In a outer class, I have taken a inner class, which is the inner class. Okay, and here I have took a method. So for calling this show, what exactly will be done? Now in public static void, man, as usual, we know that we create a object, and using that object, we call o dot show. That means this method will be called here regarding that we have created the object of outer o is equal to new outer. But how exactly we are going to call this display? In a similar way, if you try to call the display method of inner class, you will get an error. So how exactly? Now here if you see, outer O is equal to new outer. Here outer is nothing but the class, right? Outer is nothing but a class. O is the object. Using the new keyword, we have created the object. And this outer is nothing but, it's the constructor, right? And using this O dot show, I have called the method of a outer class. Now how exactly I will call this? As I told, this is the class and this is the object. And this inner class is the inner class of this outer class, right? So for that purpose, we will take the reference of this outer. Now here if you see, as I told, this is a class, right? As this is a class, so here I will take outer dot inner. So using the reference of an outer class, outer dot inner, here I will create an object of the inner class. And here, as I told, new keyword, using new keyword, we are doing the object. So here I will pass the object of outer class, that is o dot new and inner as per the constructor, and then I will call this display method. So in this way, we are going to call the methods of the inner class. That means we are going to take the reference of outer class. So this is what, how exactly we use inner class and how exactly we call the methods or the variables of a display. So that means it will be regarding the outer class. Okay, so here we will use its references. As the class can have a static members and the methods, right? In the same way, the inner class can also be a static. Okay, and now here if you see, here we have a three classes. That means here it will be outer dot class, inner demo dot class, but here it will be not inner dot class. Here what it will be? Outer, then dollar inner dot class. Just remember this also. This is also very important, because at the time of MCQ, such question will come. That means outer dollar inner dot class will be there, as because this is the inner class of this outer class. So my dear friend, this was regarding the inner class. So from next tutorial we'll start our next unit. So regarding the same, if you have any kind of question, you can mention in the comment section. And thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.